Welcome back to Tangata Pasifika. We'd love to hear from you during the show. Tweet or Facebook us. What did you think of the Korean student who won Fuataimi Prize at the Polyfest?
Yeah.
Well, next week is Hearing Week. It's one of the senses most of us take for granted.
One Cook Island's mama's hearing has been extended thanks to an implant in her inner ear. John Utanga has the story.
How is it different now you have your hearing?
The Mangere Citizens Advice Bureau and Abi Joseph is sharing her experience with colleagues. Always outgoing, she's now a much more confident person.
I can actually understand what you're saying.
No, it was a miracle. I am happy that I can have two ears to listen to instead of one.
6 days earlier, the 57-year-old grandmother was at this clinic getting an implant in her inner ear switched on.
It's going to be a little while before you hear speech.
The implants had been surgically inserted 3 weeks earlier. Until today, Api's only been able to hear through her right ear with the help of a hearing aid. She began to go deaf in her left ear when she was 16, but it wasn't till she started working that it became a big problem.
When I was at work, I realised my hearing wasn't very good there, and that's when I started going to the doctor. My doctor then said to me, okay, we don't know what's happening, so we'll keep a good eye on you. And then, of course, every winter time, that's when we have cold and everything. Yep, and that's when I went back to the doctor and said, I don't know what's wrong, but my ears hurting.
As her hearing deteriorated, Api said it became increasingly difficult at home with family.
If they're having a conversation and I didn't hear that, it was annoying to me because I quickly see it the other way around where, oh, you don't want to talk to me, eh? Sort of jealousy-wise.
Today, Api does admin and advises at the Mangere CAB. The implant will help her continue on in a role she loves. She was able to receive the implant thanks to the work of the Northern Cochlear Implant Trust and the Pindrop Foundation, a group which is keen to help more Pasifika and Māori people with hearing problems.
We are very underrepresented in the database for the adults, and that may be as a consequence of cultural issues that perhaps we don't know how to actually get people to refer themselves through the audiologist or through their GP, or perhaps, like a lot of males particularly, they do not want to admit that they have a hearing loss.
So we've got everything measured and we're ready to switch over for you to hear speech with your new ear.
Is that what you mean, switch on?
The switch on, yeah. She'll become more aware of the huge range of sounds around her. She hasn't been used, even with her other ear, she's not heard high-pitched sounds at all. What about this one?
Ew.
It's going to take a little while for her to get used to all this absolute bombardment of sound. My job is to try and make sure all that sound is comfortable so that she doesn't have to be overwhelmed by it.
So far, Abi is happy with her implant and with getting back to work. Her message to people experiencing hearing problems is simple.
My advice would be for them to, you know, seek help now. Don't leave it until too late.